First thing I want to note is that, you know, this is the global internet we're talking about. I mean, we've had other kinds of collaboration in standards, in other kinds of technology-related activities. But when we're talking about the global internet, I think we all, as a collective community, have some sense of where we would like the internet to be next year, the year after. And in order to do that, I mean, I think much of the core of the activities really comes down to standards and the technology behind the internet. Now, as you could see from, you know, the discussions, even just here, if we don't begin to pay attention to how to modify our models so that it becomes more inclusive, what is happening here is what's going to continue to happen next year, the year after. The discussion is going to be centered around certain geographic parts of the world, you know, and it's between them, you know, this is what we did and this is what our federal agency did and that sort of thing. Now, how do we begin to rectify that? I think that one of the things I saw missing in the models, and again, I repeat that the groups individually have done well, and you could see even by this conference that they are all really struggling to answer the question that you are asking now. How do we include more of the groups? But I think that one of the elements I didn't see is part of what the internet builders in the early days used, and that is universities. Okay. Now, we, using an example, but from another field, not from standards building, what we have done recently, that is the Digital Bridge Institute, we have a very solid partnership with the Berkman Center for Internet and Policy at Harvard University, and the Sam Nunn School for International Affairs, and the Computer Science Joint Program at Georgia Tech. And what we've done is the nature of this partnership is a model that I would like to explore and bring over to the area of standards. Practically, for the past 3 years, the two gentlemen from Harvard and from Georgia Tech come to the Digital Bridge Institute in Abuja. We actually sit down in my office and we decide what we're going to do for the rest of the year. Now, what we've done in those 3 years have focused on new media and how we can use the tools of the Web 2.0 to apply to several specific industries. That's what we decide in those meetings that we have in January. Now, based on that, we've had probably about 5 different workshops and then, papers that go back and forth based on that. But it is a multi-stakeholder approach. When we do that, okay, they to the universities, we are an institute, so it's sort of universities that have access to all of the resources and sort of intellectual and skills resources that you can talk about in terms of what this kind of joint collaboration. And then we are sitting on the other side, knowing the nature of the problems and maybe how to actually permeate the society in terms of the difficulties that you see in the literature, which is the difficulty that groups like IETF would have, trying to understand who to go to in Africa, how to really navigate, okay? So together, we put together this program, and we are able to then invite civil society within Nigeria. In one of the programs, I actually had 170 non-governmental groups, just civil society groups. We focused on them, okay, because we wanted to introduce certain kinds of technology-related issues, ICT-related concepts, practices that they could use, especially in getting people involved in the democratic process. So each time we focus on one element. Now, the point I'm trying to make is this. There is value in using university resources, however you craft that university resource. It could be collaboration between universities to broker, essentially, be a sort of an objective convener of the different groups that are trying to reach a certain goal. I see that working also in the area of standards. There are many people scattered around Africa. Some of them are in this room. People like Nikweno, who has been involved with this whole process from the start. There's Adele over here. Lishan Adams. There are many of those people who, if we can tap the the energy and the resources that they have built around themselves and through them get to the university communities. I keep using this university and sort of not just university, institutional communities that are more academic and training oriented, okay? To help organize and foster the ideas that will bring the international community and the African groups together to try to build towards the creation of a critical mass.